Another edition of Sam Choy's in the Kitchen. I'm John Venere. This is the chef, Sam Choy. We're visiting Leeann, and her sister Sueann's gonna join us.
Hey, I heard they love to cook and have some nice island flavors in their kitchen from what I heard.
First time on the show, we're working with twins. Sueann and Leeann and
in.
The puppy. We'll have to figure this out. Never before have we had twins on the show.
Thing one, thing two.
So who came out first?
I did.
Ah.
She kicked them off.
She kicked me out.
Kicked her out.
Okay, don't kick us out though. Can you tell we're twins too?
There's a little bit of resemblance.
Do you remember that movie Twins with Arnold Schwarzenegger and Danny DeVito?
So, so am I Arnold? All right, let's get to the chopper. Let us dig in the refrigerator.
Okay.
You see something over
here? I don't know. You see something?
I have beef shank.
So are you here a lot? You're here a lot.
Huh? I'm here a lot.
She's here a lot.
We take turns
cooking. You guys live close together.
Yeah, we take turns cooking. Some pork hash if you want.
Look, it has a date too.
Oh, look at that. It's so good.
You're frozen stuff.
Basic stuff, chicken thighs.
You weigh your food?
I like everything over here.
No, I buy everything.
Nice and.
I buy in bulk and
ready
I
to go.
Keep it,
you know, in case. Awesome.
Pork bones in case you make soup.
Okay.
How about a kala?
Has it been cleaned yet?
Yes, it's clean.
Ooh,
okay.
Here's some black fungus.
Oh,
Sam Choy, I'm Chinese.
We Wait, so
Chinese
we got a seaweed fish and black fungus. What's going on here?
I know.
But we can throw some fujok.
Fujok, my favorite item.
What?
If you like
long rice.
I've got mushrooms, water chestnuts. We got a cupboard full. And then we have a whole aquaponics garden.
Do you have ong choy?
I have ong choy in the garden growing.
Ong choy. I saw this when I walked in.
The Choy family, that's our roots. This is our roots right here.
This is your roots.
Yeah. The Choy family.
The Choy family, where's the ong?
No ong.
No ong choy.
Bok choy, white cabbage.
There we go.
Which I do have.
Wait, no, but speaking of which, we have all of that, and we still have bok choy. Here is the infamous bok choy. Yep. Everything in it, we have to incorporate into whatever meal we're doing today, so go ahead.
Okay, let Sueann do the honors.
Oh, okay.
Pop it open.
Ooh.
Oh, good. We got some. We got some sauces.
We got soy sauce.
Aloha shoy.
Oh, looks like your shirt. Very nice.
Oh, yeah. Ooh, Filipino adobo sauce.
Oh. Oh.
And all-purpose barbecue sauce.
Oh.
Okay, say bye.
Bye.
Oh.
Okay, Uncle Sam. So we got. What do we got?
We're gonna make a nice pot of soup. Okay.
Okay. What goes into that?
Well, we got the fungus, black fungus.
So we're throwing fungus.
That in that?
Fungus.
Chicken. We'll do something with the chicken. Maybe the chicken with the long rice. And then we have some nice stock products to make the stock for the soup. We got nice bones.
Pork bones.
Beef bones.
Beef bones.
So we'll make a pot of nice broth soup.
And we got seaweed fish.
Oh yeah, we got. Well, it's kala. Throw with the horn.
You said seaweed.
But they eat a lot of seaweed, so they smell and taste like seaweed. But we're going to make some. We're going to roast that.
Okay.
We're going to need some ong choy.
Okay.
Is that okay?
That sounds great.
So we got three good solid things. We got roasted. We're going to do a soup. Maybe we make some nice,
pork hash balls.
Pork hash balls, yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
These Chinese girls here, sisters, going to make their family's favorite Chinese
pork hash
balls.
Okay. I don't know how to make that, so.
What?
I cook Chinese, she cooks American.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. What?
I took after dad, she takes after mom.
Oh.
Yeah.
Let's get started.
Okay, now, John.
Perfect. Yes.
Little salt. And this is garlic powder?
Yeah.
What could you
use? Garlic salt.
Garlic salt, okay, not too much. Some pepper that's white.
That'll give it some spice.
Yeah, that'll be good.
Yeah.
John, can you give me some oil on here, please?
Okay.
Here you go.
Okay. Say when.
Okay. And then some flour.
Flour.
Right there.
Just dust it, John.
Dust it. You want me to throw it in here?
Yeah, just right there. Just go all around. So that's good. Right at this stage, you could almost, you know, get it nice and like salt and pepper shrimp, salt and pepper, you know,
and
fish.
And just throw it in a fryer.
But we're not going to do that. We're going to roast it.
Because we're roasting the collar.
That's right. A little bit of our adobo, which we're going to use this more.
Oh, it even has a bay leaf in it.
Yeah, you got the bay leaf. Okay. Yeah. And then all purpose.
How much you like?
Good. What do you think? Good.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it smells good. Wow.
That does smell delicious.
Yeah, all those sauces.
Oh, my God, he's all the sauces.
We had garlic salt, little salt, white pepper. We added Asian gold, I'll always show you. And then we added our adobo, Filipino adobo, and then all-purpose barbecue sauce. And then we'll take our fish.
The flowers of the
fish. Kind of like this.
Oh, you did the flour already, yeah.
The flour went on already. This is going to be really good. Okay, the challah is going in the oven.
Challah in the oven.
The marinated challah goes in right now. 20 minutes, we'll be done. In the pot here right now, we got the pork bones that have been rapidly boiling that we're gonna turn down to maybe like a medium high.
I smashed some ginger.
Smashed some ginger, went in, John, very nice. And then we added some garlic, then I'm gonna add some Hawaiian salt to the broth right now. You got some Hawaiian salt right there. John, put about 1 tablespoon in there, or maybe half, or maybe less. But I think we're good to go. Okay, very good, John.
What's next?
Okay, now we're gonna have Leeann and sister make the pork hash. So the ingredients we got ginger, we got little garlic, we got some nice mushrooms, shiitake mushrooms, water chestnuts, and then of course some green onions and what's your baby's name out there?
Oh, Lilo.
Lilo.
My chicken.
Her chicken lays some nice fresh island eggs.
Yeah. So that's a little over, just a smidge over 1 pound of pork hash.
Yes.
So some ginger.
Some garlic.
Some, what kind of mushrooms?
Shiitake.
What kind?
Shiitake. Thank you, John.
Sorry, my green onions.
Can you spell that for me?
S-H-I-I-T-A-K-E.
Shiitake.
I'm just messing. Okay, no, that's the water chestnut?
That's the water chestnut.
What kind of leftovers? How much leftovers you got, y'all?
Huh?
How much leftovers you got?
A lot.
Wow.
Sesame oil?
Just a little bit of sesame oil. Do you want to come out?
They come out. Yeah, a little bit. She just...
That's plenty. And then a little bit of cornstarch.
Just a little. Makes it fluffy.
Okay.
Oh, this is great.
Eggs. Do you know if you crack an egg on a counter, you get absolutely no shells? Crack it on a counter.
Yeah, no shells.
But then you spill a little bit.
Yeah. Okay, now loam me your hand, yeah.
Loam me, okay.
You're in gloves.
That's the way to do it.
I can't say it looks fabulous right now, but it does smell good.
Yeah.
That's good. Oh, yeah.
And so how are these going to be cooked?
We're going to drop them in the broth, in the soup.
So we're going to make balls and put them in the soup?
Yes.
Should I put hao yao or no?
Yeah.
How yao?
Explain how yao to everybody.
Oyster sauce.
Oh, I was going to say how yao.
So, no recipe for pork hash, just mix it all up.
Well, it's like meatloaf, right?
Yeah.
There's certain things that go in there, and there's certain things that is magic.
Yeah.
How yao is very magic.
Yeah. In the pursuit of a healthier diet, consumers are on the lookout for superfoods. Time to paint it purple. All colorful produce have antioxidants, but nutritionists say purple foods are magic because of the compound anthocyanin. And sprouts get the superfood label because of a high vitamin, mineral, and fiber content. Put them all together and you've got Rambo radish sprouts, grown here by American Renaissance Academy students at Makaha Mountain Farms.
So Rambo radish, super easy. All you need is either soil or some people even like to use mats. I mean, I've had students grow Rambo on paper towels, so really anything.
Seedlings are placed on a mixture of peat moss and perlite obsidian, and 11 days later, you've got a crop, much in demand by wholesalers and restaurants.
They love it for its color, for its texture. It's crunchy, it's succulent. I mean, it's tangy, peppery. It really awakens your palate when you take a bite into it.
Now back to Sam in the kitchen.
I'm gonna add some water chestnuts in here. Right now, look. So these are, the water chestnut kind of like holds up well, but it absorbs a lot of flavor, okay?
Next.
And then we have some pepe al. And we got some shiitake mushrooms in here that's gonna be put in for flavor. Going in. And we use some of the leftover from the
pork hash,
yeah.
Okay, next.
I'm gonna put a little bit in because this thing goes a long way. You know, just a little, but it goes a lot.
Good source of iron.
It looks like hair.
Yeah, it's hair, right? It's like a hair, that's what they call it, yeah.
So now, I'm gonna just stir it around. I want to make sure that we got it.
Come on, Uncle Sam. You know what you're supposed to do when you say the words.
Huh?
Steer it up.
Little darling, steer it up. So I'm going to add
fujuk.
Kind of put it at an angle like this.
Oh, yeah.
So the water kind of like goes all down.
Oh, yeah. Neighbors are gonna come running.
They're already wondering what the heck they're doing in that house. It's Sam Choy's in the kitchen.
We're actually eating my hurricane preparedness food.
Oh no.
Because it's all dried, right? So you just keep it just in case.
And very good. You have to go shopping again? Just
rehydrate it and cook.
She has to go shopping now for her next hurricane.
Oh man, this thing is. Drop the.
Little pork balls in there.
There's a lot of stuff in there. Can you just recap it real quick again?
Yeah, sure, John. So we got the stock bones going in broth and water.
Yep.
And we created our own flavor. So we got the Hawaiian salt in there, ginger,
garlic,
and then
bouillon cubes,
and then we started adding. So we got the mushrooms, about four or five different kind of mushrooms in there, and then they're adding the pork hash, and then we ordered the dried bean curd.
Then we got pho choy.
Yeah, pho choy, right? That's the.
And we got the fujuk.
Fujuk, yeah. We got all that in there. Don't stir it, I'll let it just poach.
Yeah, it's sitting on the top.
Until it kind of like.
Very good, can I look?
Sitting on the top.
Oh, okay. It has been 20 minutes now for the fish.
All right, let's check the fish.
Okay, fish is pow. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Looky.
Ooh.
Okay, so we get a nice little platter.
Okay.
We're gonna put it on our platter, and then we'll garnish it.
We're gonna add a little bit of oyster sauce.
Oyster sauce. Yeah.
It looks really perfectly cooked.
Smells good. Yeah.
Okay, that's good. That's good.
That's good.
And then, are you okay?
Yeah.
You're shaking. Just right in the middle.
We need the boomerang.
Right here in the middle.
Yeah. And then we have our first dish.
Oh, nice. What'd you put in there?
I got a little bit of garlic and ginger minced, a little bit oil. Then I'm gonna add a little bit of salt, a little bit of Asian gold, I'll always show you. And then of course, some garlic salt, and then a little cornstarch. And that's kind of like gonna be basically, you know, my style of cooking. Some people don't do this, but I like to do that. Mm-hmm. A little oyster sauce, a little ginger.
Some sugar.
Sugar, and then I'll show you.
Asian gold.
Yeah, and that's
and
it.
And mirin.
Yeah. Okay, so now we're getting ready to go to the walk.
Yes. Are we gonna walk to the walk or are we running to the walk?
Well, in my earlier days, I would kind of stumble to the walk. Now I crawl to the walk.
Okay, chicken in the walk. I like the way that you did that. You added it to the side.
Yes, because you don't get splashed.
Oh, yeah.
And then onion, celery.
We don't have celery.
Oh, yeah, we do.
You had celery in there.
I had celery.
Oh, you did?
He had celery.
Oh, I thought you had celery in your fridge.
Threshold them, Uncle Sam.
The steak?
Let Leeann do it.
Or let the onion shake.
Come on, do the push-pull, Leeann.
Yeah, do your shoot.
Yeah, this is her kitchen, man.
I don't know about that part.
So if you take notice, we didn't season anything.
Yeah, we didn't, because it was in the chicken.
That's right. The flavor is in the chicken. We're going to add a little salt and pepper, but we'll do that at the end. Okay, John?
Yup.
Your turn.
You're going to add, John's going to add the sauce, and then you can add the long rice.
Oh, okay.
All of it. Show the long rice in there, John. You know, the Samoans, they have something similar. They call it sapa suey or chop suey. It's really good.
Why is that Samoan?
Because they, you know, a lot of Chinese people live in Samoa.
A lot of Chinese live in Samoa.
Yeah. Okay, now you can add the watercress. And the soy, the white stem.
How you do?
It's too heavy.
Oh, man. You saw that, John.
Here. Pass off.
Here, Uncle Sam, you do it.
He told me I was burning it.
Oh, you saw the toss? He tossed it.
Woo! Here we go. Okay. Oh, yeah.
Oh, man, look at this.
That looks really good.
It has some garnish.
Oh, man. Hey, you're very good. You must have worked at some...
I must have worked at a hotel like you.
Yeah.
HEKKA, Kala, done.
Man, this is amazing, John. You know why? The Ong Choy came from her garden, and then all the goodies we got in there.
Okay, I think this is done. Do you know what time it is?
Time to grind.
Oh, wait.
Time to grind.
There we go, time to grind. Uncle Sam, let's recap.
Oh, man.
They're grinding already. Go ahead. Let's go ahead and tell them what they're eating.
Yeah, well, first of all, we start off with the kala, which was called in kaava, marinated lightly, salt, pepper, and then we added our aloha shoyu, the adobo sauce, and the all-purpose barbecue sauce. And we put it in a pan, and we threw it in the oven for 20 minutes at 350. And then our next dish we did was our soup that we had a nice assortment of goodies.
The suli soup.
The suli soup. We had a nice pork bones, we made the broth, right?
Mm-hmm.
Fujuk, and then the four different kind of mushrooms, shiitake, pepeao.
And the fat choy.
Fat choy.
The what?
The fat choy.
The hair, the monk's hair. And then, of course, the girls did the nice
pork hash.
Very good. Mm-hmm. And then you guys went out to your ranch on the farm and harvested the ong choy.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, it was good.
The ong choy and the watercress.
Yep.
Yes.
We had the chicken and it was stir fried.
Yep.
And then you made the sauce to add the stir fry. So we had the vegetables, stir fried the chicken, added the vegetables, then we added the sauce.
And the long rice.
And the long rice, and you added the mirin.
Sorry, she needed to get
it. Jubilee.
She needed to get some action.
And so what is your favorite? We'll start with soup.
The HEKKA.
Mm.
It was delicious.
Yeah.
Yep.
I'm a soupy person.
Yeah?
Yep. Love the soup. Flavor is very good.
And I like it all. Because I'm a food person.
Uh-huh.
And this is super good food. And for those that have never had kala, this is a great way to cook it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And healthier.
Yeah.
What's it like being twins?
We don't know. We don't have regular sisters. But it's fun. It's always fun. Like we kind of coordinated our outfits without knowing.
Your hair is different.
almost different. We have the different same color. Hairdresser, yeah.
Same hairdresser.
Yeah.
His job is to make us look different.
Ah, right off the bat, make us look different.
Yeah. But when we go to the restaurant, we can look at the menu and I would be able to know what she's gonna eat before she even tells me.
Really?
Because she was gonna order the same thing.
We ordered the same thing.
Really?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Kind of weird.
And we are identical by 6 minutes.
Okay.
6 minutes apart.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you guys for coming over.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, thank you for having us and let us dig in your fridge and cook a little bit. But remember,
when Sam Choy's in the kitchen,
you can do the cooking.
Chef Sam Choy.
I'm gonna save this and make a wallet for you.
Oh, perfect. You know what? Perfect. That's perfect.
Kala in
Kala is money.
Yep. There you go.
Kala wallet. So you're, go. This wallet will always be full.